afternoon. It's the 25th of April and it's another sunny day out there. I'm speaking from the hot tub shed, as you can see. It's a bit quieter in here. It's a bit noisy in there with the telly, etc. How's it going with the lockdown? Getting a bit boring now, isn't it? Yeah, getting a bit like cabin fever. Struggling for finding things to do. Dizzy Daisy yesterday has created a vlog on some things you can do while you're in lockdown. She's created this herself. It's all of her own work. All I've done is take it off her phone and put it into this vlog. So please enjoy and let us know if you like it. Here it is.
Today I decided to do a vlog. It's Dizzy Daisy here, and today I'm going to be doing what to do when you're home bored. So, just gotta pull up that. So the first thing is, hang on, let me grab it. Try to solve a Rubik's cube. I have absolutely no idea how to do these. My mum did a full-on Santa side for me. And I messed that up. Sorry, Mama. Apology might not be accepted because I am pretty annoying. But that's all right. So try to solve a Rubik's Cube because these are actually pretty hard. See, I already got like one line of presents. So, like there's a present right there and there and there. So like, I need to try and get those on. There's like two more presents missing. But I can't get that, so I'm just gonna keep on twisting and turning it because why not? You have nothing else to do, so why not try and spend your time and try to solve the thing you have absolutely never solved in your life. Oh, I got some Santas. Yes, Santa. Okay, so yeah, I'm going to do this for a little and see if I can do it. I'll come back and then give you an update of how I've done the Rubik's Cube, like how I'm doing on the Rubik's Cube, and then I will say the next thing. Okay, so the next thing you can do is drawing. I have this sketch pad and I've done lots of really good sketches in here. You can also play MASH. Which stands for this thing. So this is my sister's future. It's not real, you just do it for fun. So her job is going to be a teacher. She's going to have a pet pony. Her transport is going to be by bus. So she's a teacher, she has a pony, and she has a bus that's like she has to catch a bus. And she lives in a mansion, which, and then I'm going to tell you all the choices I put on here. So for jobs, I put nurse, teacher, cashier, paramedic. A paramedic is basically one of those people that go out and in ambulances. One came from my granddad for ambulances and like see if you're all right, decide if you have to go to hospital on that or that. Yeah, so that's all the jobs. For transport, I put limo, bike and van. Limo is just like your personal own limo. And then for houses, I put mansion, cottage, bungalow or shack. But cottage, I want to live in a cottage. And then the pets, I put doggy, dog, cat, pony or horse. Yes, there's a difference in between pony and horses. The bigger one's bigger and one's smaller. Anyways, and then this is the one Katie put. For jobs, she put singer, actor, nurse, or nothing. And nothing. I'm going to tell you what she put and then I'll tell you what I got. Nothing. Transport, car, bike, skateboard, none. Marriage, Billie Eilish. like Billie Eilish. Selena Gomez. Well, whoever that... Demi Lovato, sorry. Selena Gomez and Zac Efron. And, yeah. Then home. Mansion. Mansion, home. Apartment, homeless. And pet, none. Hamster and a cat. And this is what I got. I got my job was nothing. Transport, skateboard. Marriage, Zac Efron. Not gonna lie, but I'm happy with him as well because it's that Billie Eilish. I love her music. Oh. I could listen to that all day. But I got Zac Efron. Hottie. when I saw The Greatest Showman, I'm like, Mum, who's that guy that sang to that person on a rope? She said, that's Zac Efron. And I'm like, because I had a crush on him. And my home is homeless. So I have a skateboard, I have no job, and I'm married to Zac Efron. My pet is a hamster. So I'm homeless with a hamster. My only transport is a skateboard, and I'm married to Zac Efron. No. Anyways, so you can also play MASH, and you can also do a sketching. So I'm going to do like a nice sketch. I'll come back once I've done a sketch. I'm doing it on green paper, so yeah, and I'm using this to lean against, so yeah. And I also have a pencil with me, so I'm going to use that. Guys, so I'm going to put it in time lapse. Please ignore the bangs at the background. It's just people being silly in front of fireworks. So I'm going to put it in time lapse. And yes, I'm not lying, I do have a pencil. So I'm going to put it in time lapse. So guys, it is actually going pretty good. I drew two things so far, and I'll show you here. The lips, and I also drew that. So yeah, that's what you can draw. As you can see, it's like school paper, so like from school, from a long time ago. And I brought it home and tried drawing an eye. It didn't work, but it's okay now. But I actually did draw those. Next thing, if you have a reborn toddler or reborn, I asked my sister for a binder. And right here it's got like all of her work in it. Pretty soon I'll do like a reborn routine. So like we have ABC right here. We have maths. There's a couple sheets in there and art. I think I might take that one off and put like finish work on it because it just makes more sense. And I don't want to give her too much trouble. And yes, I did use the pencil in this because I do not have any sharpeners because all my pencils like under my bed, and like most of them are unsharpened, and I don't want to ruin those. And right here there's like a chain, so I attach that to the binder and then close it so like I won't ever lose it. So that's another thing you can print off work for your doll. Next thing, you can clean. You can actually clean. You can like dust a bit, help your parents, which I actually have been doing lately. So I'm going to do a little bit of dusting, so I'll come back when I've done that. Thank you. I did a bit of cleaning right there. Not much, because I actually did lots of cleaning on my bedroom. So, yes, so I'm going to go downstairs for the other things that you can do. Okay, guys, so I got this our book. So I have the hiccups. I know you're probably all shouting, rah, rah, at your screen, but it's not going to work, guys. So these are like a couple things of what you can make. I'll come back once I've found a couple. Here you can make some cheese scones, plain scones, or like Ritz scones. We'll make a couple of those. There's Victoria scones, they are like really nice. You can make rock buns, potato scones, grilled scones. I do not recommend any of these. I'm just recommending to like things you can cook. We have dropped scones, granny loaf, Welsh grilled cakes, an orange rising loaf. So like, I'm gonna come back once I got to like all the cakes, because that's what you guys are probably interested in. I'm at the cakes. So like, you can make fruit cake. That is actually gorgeous. I like fruit cake. Fruit cake's actually really healthy. Well, it isn't. Oh my god, sorry. We have coconut and orange cake. Sorry, I got the hiccups. And I'm sounding like my half sister. Don't like it. Anyways, we have milk chocolate cake. That's probably what my dad will like. So probably when he edits this, he's gonna be like, now that's an idea. Haha, got your dad. There's rich cakes. Creaming method. That's a long list. There's Victoria's sandwich. So you could make that, guys. Victorians, like most orange cake, queen cake, and cherry buns. Oh look, birthday cakes. Right, so I might pass a little bit of recipes on to me mum, because my birthday is absolutely coming up soon, and I want like a little party. So we have vibrations. Victorians? I don't know. I can't read, guys. I'm only on year four. We have chocolate buns. Francis. Butterfly cakes. Birthday gratitude. That looks good. Serves 12. Extra for the birthday girl. We have Victorians. More like Victorians. Chocolate grant to you, coffee grant to you, ew. One toolkit, fudge cake, walnut fudge cake. Sorry, I'm finding it hard to read. There's chocolate spice cake, rich buns, Victorian, the terrible cake, celebrity fruit cake. Recipe,
what are you making?
Quarantines. Oh.
Oh, are you?
Shh, do not do that. I'm vlogging for my dad. I don't want it to be a surprise. You can also make recipe quarantines. I don't know what that means. Rich Dund cake. It's Snimal cake. It's like we're kind of in like Christmas cakes, but that's all right, because why not? There's whisking method. Sponge sandwich basic recipe. It's like just like a different method. Swiss rolls. Sponge flan. There's a gingerbread, you can make that gingerbread cake. and brownies. I'd recommend popular brownies, if I'm honest. And then now we're on the quick and easy. So it's like going to be a different day. So that's another thing you can do whilst you're trapped at home. So I'm just going to go put this cookbook back. Thank you guys for watching. I got some merch on today. It's a billy top for me. So I got some merch on. So bye-bye for now. Bye.